Good morning to everyone. Now we call upon Mr. Lokesh, third year UC department, to give the talk about what is entrepreneurship. Thank
you. A very warm welcome to one all present here. This is the first time a college is going to compete in an entrepreneurship challenge. First of all, you must know what is entrepreneurship. How long after 4 years of hardship in engineering, you're going behind someone for employment? Why you can't be the someone? We thank our management for giving this amazing opportunity to compete in an NEC ESL. What is NEC? National Entrepreneurship Challenge. Flipkart, in association with IIT Mumbai, are organizing this challenge. Since there's lack of awareness among our country youngsters in this entrepreneurship, my co-mates will explain more about entrepreneurship and famous entrepreneurship to you. Thank you.
Hi everyone. I am Indra, and our paper will be mainly discussing on what is the basics of entrepreneurship and who are all the famous entrepreneurs. So I will be proceeding with what is the basics of entrepreneurship. Shall we proceed?
Yes.
Okay. What is basically an entrepreneur? If you see the slide, it just states it's the ability to foresee or ascertain the various opportunities related with the investment. Evaluate these opportunities and forming enterprise and give the maximum contribution to the nation's growth. Okay, this is a technical aspect. Can anyone say me what is entrepreneurship in your point of view?
Starting up the own business and taking risks.
Yeah, you're correct. Yeah. As he said, you can also define entrepreneurship as starting up a business on his own and through his progress, they'll through the innovations, they'll be making a progress. So, in order to become wealthy. Next. Okay, let me discuss about the characteristics of entrepreneurship. If you see, we'll be discussing about the five characteristics, namely the interest and vision, skills, investment, organization and delegation, and risks and rewards. So, first, let me talk about the interest. So I'll ask you, everyone has interest, right?
Yes.
Only when you select your field according to your interest, you can reach success. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
So if you see, when you talk about the characteristic of an entrepreneur, what is an entrepreneur should first select his field of interest. Only when he selects his field of interest, the interest can translate into a vision. This vision only helps him to communicate effectively. So next is skill. I'll ask you a question. If you have a vision and interest, is this enough to get success?
No.
So we should have some skill. If you're going to choose anything as a particular field, you should have some specialized skill over that. So what I'm trying to say is, an entrepreneurship should have specialist knowledge of where he is going to work or his field of interest. For example, if you see this slide, for instance, if he's going to start a business in mobile games, one should have specialist knowledge in game design, mobile technology, and mobile app marketing or programming. Next. Investment. This is very mandatory for entrepreneurship. Basically, an entrepreneur should invest primarily on his own. Only when he invests primarily on his own, others can trust him and others can join us. Others can join him. So this is what investment. Next, organization and delegation. For any work, we have to organize and we have to coordinate everyone. Right. So for equity and stable growth, an entrepreneur must have the idea of what person to choose and where they have to be given the job. Like hire right people to do the specialist job, and he has to have a contact, and he has to have a thorough knowledge of what is going around him. And the main point in any organization or anything where we work is we have to allow them work free. That is what the main point is. Risks and rewards. Starting from our life, we'll be adding risks. According to the risk, we'll be adding the rewards, right? So, here, risk equates to the amount of time and money and investment, and also proportional to the reward. what's involved. Sometimes an entrepreneur can think some groundbreaking innovations. Sometimes it may end up in success, or sometimes it may drown him down. So this is what is all about the characteristics. So now let us see. We are saying he is a successful entrepreneur. He is not a successful entrepreneur. So we need to know the cause. What has created him to become successful, or what are the causes? So what I am going to explain is, what are the major factors involved in successful entrepreneur? So first is viable business model. Firstly, an entrepreneur should know his surrounding locality. That is, he must be able to know who are the companies competing with him, and what is the current market strategy and how to overcome this. So if you see the slide, you can have a clear view, like conducting in-depth market research, having knowledge of the competition, a well-defined financial and marketing strategy. Next is self-discipline. As a student and as any person, we must have some self-discipline. But regarding the entrepreneurship, the most important thing to be noted is commitment is very necessary. Only when you have a commitment towards work, you can reach success. So what commitments you can have is commitment towards work and staying on the top of the industry trends. An entrepreneur should have a thorough knowledge, and he must be continually networking, and whenever there is a sudden change in the market strategy, he has to change himself and then readapt to the changes. So next. Business financing. This is another important criteria. If you see the business financing, he must have detailed knowledge. Suppose if he is not able to cope up with the money or somewhat, he must be able to plan accordingly. So he has to write some plans and applying for loans or grants or seeking investors, etc. So next. Stress management. This is very important for everyone of this, right? So only when we can manage our stress, we can come up with some good ideas, some good thoughts, etc. So what is an entrepreneur should be able to handle the stress that comes as line of force, and he must be able to coping up the stress, he must be able to talk it and effectively communicate to the investors.
Amra has been explaining you about the characteristics of an entrepreneur. In the future, we are more likely to become a successful entrepreneurs on the gathered group. So now I'm going to say what is the role of an entrepreneur in developing the entrepreneurship. First thing, we must create a friendly environment for our employees. They must feel free to express their ideas. See, business ideas are like the flying dragons in Avatar, you might have seen. So we must be ready to we must have the brave to ride it, right? And next, we must help them to develop these essential qualities of an entrepreneur, like time management, communication skills, as she has listed. And later, we must be transparent in our business solving problems, so that our employees can learn from us how to stay productive and how to solve these problems they are coming in their path. Next. We must invite our employees to emulate the right behavior. As a fact says that people who are surrounded by an entrepreneur are more likely to become an entrepreneur themselves. We must fund them with the necessary materials and the human resources that are essential for them to reach their goal. Later, to our maximum, we must provide our moral support and mentoring to the employees facing the struggles. Why the development of entrepreneurship could be a question mark in everyone's heart. First, if we know the advantages of the entrepreneurship, we learn that it is very crucial to develop entrepreneurship in our country. First one is generation of employment. See, unemployment is increasing in our country day by day. So when we become an entrepreneur, we are self-employed, as well as we have the opportunity to employ the unemployed people. By this, we are able to contribute to the economic development of our nation, as well as we are doing a very great job in removing poverty from our country. Next. Next is increase in the per capita income of an nation. See, as a person's income increases, not only contributes well to his own business, but also to the nation as a whole. See, the per capita income of a nation is calculated as nothing but the ratio of the total income of a person by that of the population. Next. It's helpful in the capital information. See, when we ask, we become an entrepreneur, we need to know the right investment, the right amount, and we need to proper utilization of the funds. When we invest in our own company, it would give a proper return. Next. Balance regional development. See, when an entrepreneur, he comes, he's been developed from a poor background, he's developed, but he can also able to develop the background area of him. So by this, we can have a balanced growth and employment all our country. Next. Next is providing self-reliance and self-sufficient. When we are self-employed, we have all the powers to take the decision. We are the one-man company. And we are also responsible for all the successes and failure, which we fetch along with our team members. Next. Now let us see how far the entrepreneurship growth has been in our country. And let us see what are the major causes for that. First is entrepreneurial education. In this stage itself, we have been given the opportunity to learn what is entrepreneurship and how to become an entrepreneur. That's a very great thing, you know. Next is formation of new business communities. In this growing globe, we are more business communities have been getting formed. So we have the opportunity to be part of themselves. Increasing demand of variety. See, this modern world, there is a great demand for everything in life. So when we become an entrepreneur, if we are able to meet those demands with the things, we will be definitely successful. The next is increasing flow of information. Nowadays we have various medias and internet through which we can be updated ourselves every day. Next is easier access to resources. With the increase in technology, we are able to access the resources at the right time, and the right usage will fetch you the success. Next. As a coin has a two sides, there is advantage. An entrepreneur can face the success as well as he can face the failure. If he understand what is the cause of his failure, he can develop success from this failure. As we all know, discouragement and failure are the sure stepping stone of the success. First reason for a failure might be believing that situations are unchangeable. See, abolish the negative thinking attitude from yourself. Always have a positive thinking attitude, which might fetch you to the right path. And believing money is absolute and you can't take action until you have it. See, money is a source to accomplish our jobs, but the main thing lies in our innovations and our hard work and dedication, what we are putting towards that job. Next is focusing on the past, ignoring the present and doubting the future. As long as we just feel about the past and doesn't take any action to think about our future, that is worth this. Next, waiting to act until 100% is ready. See, time will wait for none. So whenever opportunities come, we must catch it. Opportunities seeks for chance, but as an entrepreneur, you must make new chances. I'm just going to say about the top entrepreneurs of India. First is Azim Premji. Next. He's the chairman of Wipro Technologies and he's running one of the largest software companies in the globe, as we all know. Because as he was the top entrepreneur and the richest man in the world, he was honored by the Padma Bhushan Award in the year 2005. Apart from this, he has been a source of inspiration for the new developing entrepreneurs in our country. Mukesh Ambani, he is the elder among all the Ambani brothers and he is the chairman and managing director of Philips Industries Limited. According to the Forbes, he is ranked as the richest man fourth in the world. Also, the same year, he was awarded the Business Leader of the Year by the NETV. Sunil Bhatimuthar, next. He is the founder of the famous mobile network Actor. His company has made more than 180 million subscribers to enjoy their services provider, and he won the IT Man of the Year Award 2002 by the Data Press and CEO of the award from the World Methodic Congress. Next.
gifted skill that would be present in anyone. It's a dream of every person sitting over here to secure a job, isn't it? Then to secure a job, if you are thriving for it so much, then think about being an entrepreneur. You are going to make your own money. You are going to employ other people in your own company, and you are giving chances to other people. You look at the HR who come to recruit us in the campus, right? We are quite amazed to see, look at their position. Then imagine what would be the perception of people when they look at us, when we are the entrepreneurs. So it is a status that we are going to give it for ourselves. So it is more about being inspired to be an entrepreneur than being like thinking on it and just becoming one. So to be an entrepreneur, I would say, there are a few important things that you'll have to develop. First thing is, you'll have to decide on what your skill set is. Like, you have to focus on what your strength is and develop your skill set about it, I mean around what interests you the most. So that will help you strengthen your knowledge about a particular thing. So if you are working on something that interests you more, then you are going to work more on it and you are going to be more committed to it, and eventually you are going to be more successful. So that is the first thing that you have to have to be a successful entrepreneurship. Second thing is, and investment and all those are secondary, you can always arrange for those after a certain amount of difficulty, but that is possible. Apart from investment, as I already said, the commitment and skill set development is very essential. Moreover, I would say that academic part of what we study in college is very minimum when it comes to requirement of how to become an entrepreneur. To become an entrepreneur, what we learn in college is very minimal, and that is why there are so many people in the world who have set examples, and we can learn from them that college education or school education is like, it is in no way related to being an entrepreneur. We know that Mark Zuckerberg, founder of Facebook, CEO of present Facebook, right? So he is college passed out, he didn't complete his degree, but still how has he been successful? He is youngest billionaire in the world today. So that is one example that I quote to as a source of inspiration for we youngsters. Next one is Bill Gates. See, he is again passed out from college, right? He didn't complete his engineering too. So what he did is, he thought that I know something about software, so I just work on this. Why should I study something which I don't like? And he just dropped out of the college. And what he did after that, the most important thing is, whichever interested him, the software skills that interested him, he worked on it so much that he initially worked for a few days in the Apple and then founded his own company, Microsoft, which is not in the world even today. Like he's still in second or third, right? So to be an entrepreneur is just the noble idea that you'll have to strike your mind. It is not about college education, it's not about what you have learned till now, it's about what your inspiration is. What you thrive to become is more important. So come on friends, our college has given us this opportunity to let us make good use of it. We have planned to set up an easel in our college, and the major initiatives that we would take up is initially is to create awareness among all the students in the college to let them know about what entrepreneurship is, and to help them develop the skill sets to become an entrepreneur. And gradually we'll try to work on what all other initiatives we can take up in the college campus to help our students gather more information about being an entrepreneur. So for this opportunity, I thank our department HOD, Dr. M.P. Chitra, our staff, Mr. Ganesh, and all the faculty members who have extended their helping hand towards making this event a successful one. And all those who are present here, thank you for your presence.